noticed the stormwater problem all the way on the road already with no construction, and we've already got runoff with nowhere to go. This is the longest limb. It extends 89 feet from the trunk. The canopy of the Angel Oak shades an area of 17,100 square feet. The trunk of the tree is over 29 feet in circumference, and it's about 65 feet tall. All three sides of the Angel Oak are going to be surrounded by condos. There's a 150-foot buffer from the tree, but we have expert reports, and the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, the South Carolina Department of Natural Resources, and the Coastal Conservation League, the South Carolina Department of Archives, all disagree with that and don't think that a 150-foot buffer will be sufficient to protect the tree. They're going to clear-cut this entire forest outside of the 150-foot buffer, and the surrounding trees protect the Angel Oak from wind and harsh sunlight, and that's another thing that has helped it live all of these years. In order for it to have grown like this, the ecosystem has to be almost completely perfect. So if you alter that, no matter how many paid consultants a developer could have that say it's going to be okay, if you alter that even in a tiny way, you're jeopardizing the life of a national monument. Could either get too much or too little water, and that is what will kill it. Old trees like this sometimes take 25 years to die, so the people who are killing it aren't going to see it. It's not going to happen in their lifetime. It's going to be our lifetime and our children's lifetime. So something about when you're standing at the base of the tree, it makes you see the world through the eyes of a child again. You don't understand. Sometimes it takes something like this to make you understand how little you are and to make you understand how connected the world is. I know, isn't that crazy? So I was here every day, and I started talking to people, and when I found out about it, I just sort of panicked, and I went online and found this website that let me create a petition. So I created an online petition, and within 10 minutes, there's almost 100 signatures. Within 2 weeks, there are over 2,000 signatures, and people just reached out to me. I called the South Carolina Department of History, the Coastal Conservation League, the Department of Natural Resources, like any environmental group, the Sierra Club, and no one really wanted to help at first. And everyone sort of referred me to someone else and said maybe they can help. And so I just started pretty much gathering public support, and the community got behind me, and that's when it really made a difference.
Did you ever think when you started to try and save this tree that you'd have so many people stand up behind you and that you could make such a difference?
No, that's what this tree has definitely proved to me, that anything is possible, that I cannot tell you how many people, every city employee, every government employee has said it's a done deal. There's nothing you can do. Everyone said that to me and sort of looked at me like, you poor little young idealistic girl, you're not going to make a difference. And here we are, December of 2009, and construction was supposed to start in January of 2008. To date, not a single tree on this land has been touched, and that is solely because of the efforts of the community to protect it.